We were worth a couple of saddles and two big bags of grain. The big man owned the horses and they owned us just the same. 60 years ago, boys, I rode for the Diamond Team, sailing by 8 feet high on horses quick as dreams.
Hi, this is Roland Millington and you're watching Backyard Horsemanship. Hey, I just wanted to talk to a few people about, they had asked me some questions about what on earth they can wear to help keep them warm in cold weather riding, okay? So I'm going to tell you a few things about what I wear to help keep me warm when I'm out there riding, and maybe that'll give you a couple of tips to stay warm. First thing, obviously, it's cold. Wear layers. They always tell you wear layers, 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 layers. Lighter layers are better than heavier layers, okay? One of the things I'm going to tell you is your outer layer needs to be a heavy wind-resistant coat, okay? Whether it's canvas, whether it's like my oilskin duster, I love that thing, and heavy-duty wind and everything like that when it's really, really nasty out. If I really have to go out and ride, I'll wear that because it's also waterproof. Very important, especially when you've got snow flying all over the place. The other thing that I would have to say is on the inside of my coat is a wool, or excuse me, not a wool, but a fleece, okay, a polar fleece vest, all right? Inside of that is a little bit heavier material shirt, okay? It's long sleeve, a little bit extra in the length so that when I reach out and grab my reins, I don't end up exposing a lot of my skin, okay? Beyond that, I also wear two different pairs of pants, okay? What I'll usually wear is a heavier cotton canvas type of pair of pants or an army fatigue, which is what I'm wearing now, okay? You can see that the army fatigue is a little bit loose, okay? So I've got a lot of mobility here. Underneath of that army, you know, on the bottom on my legs, I wear half shafts, okay? These are just standard weaver style, you know, four flap and a buckle top type of half shafts. Underneath of the army fatigues, which you can see are plenty loose, allow me for mobility, okay, a great deal of mobility, I actually have a pair of fleece pants, okay? Now these fleece pants are the same as this type of fleece material here. They help keep me warm. They're a little bit loose, okay, but they have a lot of stretch in it so I don't bind up at the knee, okay? And I can all just sit there and tuck this all in, button it all up. It fits around my waist nice, doesn't bind up on my waist, and it keeps me warm. All right? What that helps to do is to keep your core temperature regulated, all right? Especially when you've got your blood going out to try to keep your fingers and toes warm, okay? These layers, and especially like the half chaps, will help to keep your legs warm, okay, and your toes warm, but it's also very important because the blood that's returning hasn't been cooled to any great degree by going down to the tips of your toes and warming them up. What I normally wear on my hands are a pair of simple old Westchester deerskin gloves, okay? If it's really particularly cold outside though, what I will wear is usually a pair of waterproof hunting gloves, okay? Some people can get the shotgun style gloves that have the mitten top that comes over top of them so that when they're riding, they've also got a rubberized inside, okay? So you've got a little bit of grip there so you won't get a rein pulled out of your hand or you won't drop things as easily. Next thing I want to talk to you about a little bit is about what you put in your horse's mouth. Now most people should be moving their bits inside as soon as it gets down to freezing temperatures or temperatures that can be really really cold inside of the horse's mouth. Think about it. You're standing outside all day. The last thing that you really want to do is put some ice cream in your mouth. Boy, that would just chill your body temperature down. Now mind you, you would eat the ice cream. You don't eat the bit, but still it's uncomfortable. What I recommend is either a rope style hackamore, and this is a Pirelli version, okay, and it's pretty nice in the simple fact that it's just a straight up rope style halter, okay, and it's tied around, comes out in a set of reins and a rope that basically you can use just like a Makati, all right? You've got an extra, you know, emergency brake if you need it. You tie it up through your belt or through your belt loop or around the horn of your saddle for the Western riders. If you're riding English and you're going to use a rope-style hackamore, I recommend you tie it up through your belt because you got no saddle horn. Life goes on. All right, the next thing you can do is try a side pull or a bosal. You can also try a mechanical hackamore. I'm going to tell you a little bit about mechanical hackamores. A lot of people don't like them. Some people do like them. Hunters who actually pack out meat and stuff like that in the great outdoors, and they actually camp overnight, they'll usually use something like this when it's bitter cold, when they aren't going to be able to keep a bit warm, and they know that it's going to be kind of difficult to keep a bit warm. This way you don't necessarily stick a cold piece of metal in a horse's mouth. Okay. One of the things you want to be careful for is make sure you've got a good flexible nose band. All right, this has been out here and it's in freezing temperatures. It's about 20 degrees outside right now. Probably get down to about 14 tonight, so it's not super cold, but it's cold enough. What this has is a suede top. Okay, it's got a rubberized inside, so you can see it's mobile. There's no bike chain in here or anything like that. All right, but you want to be careful and make sure that your horse has thick enough skin and thick enough fur over top of his nose, or this could really wear in and cause a serious amount of discomfort, especially where the horse has sharp nose bones, okay? If he's got a rounded profile there, I think you're going to be okay with something like this. But make sure you really take into account the thickness of the skin, the thickness of the fur, and just exactly how wide this is, okay? If it's a thin one, it's going to cut in. It's like a pencil bow style, it will cut in, okay? Be relatively severe. These are somewhat heavy, give or take. It's about the same. It's a little bit heavier than an average O-ring bit. Okay. The other thing is that if you want to use a mechanical hackamore, you can try an English style, which has a wider flat band that has a fleece underside on it. Okay. If your horse is thin skin, thin fur, that's what you might want to try. And those are just a couple of ideas. Go down to your local tack store, talk with a knowledgeable horseman or salesperson there, and really talk about whether or not you need this. There are also a variety of little bit warmer packs that you can put out there while you're brushing out your horse. You put the bit warmer on the bit, and it puts a nice warm bit in his mouth, and that's always a good thing. The happier your horse is, the better off you're going to be. Hey, this is Backyard Horsemanship, and I just want you guys to go out there, have a great day riding, enjoy the snow that's coming, enjoy the weather that's coming, but be safe about it, okay? Wear layers, take them off if you start getting hot, put them on if you start getting cold, and make sure you take your horse's comfort into mind as well. And that reminds me of one thing. When you untack your horse, if you're just a pasture kind of guy like me, always remember to try to rough up the fur on the back where the saddle's been sitting on his back, okay, and reintroduce some air back in under there instead of keeping it compressed like that. That can also help a great deal. Don't work your horse too hard either. Don't make him sweat unless you can put him in and cool him out so that all of that perspiration in the undercoat can dry out and evaporate and he can stay warm and happy. Be safe. Have some great rides out there. I'll talk to you soon.
Sailing by 8 feet high on horses quick as dreams.